Hi, and welcome to the Undecided presentation for MTSU Customs. And this is actually a pre-customs video that I've been able to prepare for you. My name is Tamika Mitchell, and I'm the academic advisor that works with students who are undecided. So in essence, I will be your advisor as long as you are an undecided student. When you participate in day one of customs, you will also have the opportunity to meet two other individuals within University College. One will be Rodney Robbins, whose name is also on the screen. He is the advising manager for University College. And then also Dr. Rick Sluter. Dr. Sluter is the vice provost for student success, and he's also the dean for University College. So, as an undecided student, you may have in our MTSU literature or in talking with people have heard the term undecided, undeclared, or you are pursuing general education. All of those terms are absolutely correct to describe you as being the undecided student. In our academic focus, and if we wanted to have the formal title of what your area of study is at this moment, it would be academic focus undecided, and that undecided insinuates the general education core. That means you are a degree-seeking student, however, you're not degree-granting, so you won't receive a degree as an undecided major or within the undecided program, but you are definitely degree-seeking. What does being an undecided student look like? Well, one, you will be assigned an academic advisor, which I've already introduced myself and made you aware that I will be your advisor. We will work together to choose your courses carefully. We want to be intentional and strategic about the general education courses that you take, ensuring that they will count for whichever degree program you select. Some majors will require specific courses, so we'll be intentional about the courses that we. Also, as an undecided student, we will engage in discussions regarding degrees, degree options, and careers. We will explore careers together. I'll provide you the necessary support that when you're ready to make your major decision or decide on a career area that you're confident and you only decide make that decision once and you're able to transition well to your major. And then I will assist you when it comes to changing your major. When you're ready to change your major, I will ensure that you're connected to the appropriate advisor. You understand exactly what will be required to complete that particular major, that area of study. And then I will assist in transitioning you from working with myself to a new advisor. So a little bit of homework I have for you before day one of customs. I want you to review the majors and concentrations that we offer at MTSU. So when you're reviewing this list or the majors that we have available, I want you to identify which majors stand out to you, which majors spark your interest. And on the contrary, also, which ones can you go ahead and rule out utilizing that process of elimination? If you know there's certain areas that you do not want to study or do not want to pursue, you can go ahead and eliminate those. The goal for this little assignment is for you to, one, become familiar with what majors we have available, but two, if you can kind of narrow down your areas of interest to maybe five, and if it's a little more, that's fine. But I want that to be a starting point for us to begin discussing what majors of interest you might have. And this will especially be helpful when we have our individual advising sessions and begin looking at what courses you're going to take in the fall. So this is the list here of the academic majors and programs. It's also included in the handbook that you have. So review this list and again, begin that processing. What majors do you find interesting? What majors are not interesting? And let's see what you can come up with. There's some additional information that I want to talk to you about. One is University 1010. University 1010 is a freshman seminar course that we offer for freshman students. It is really an intro to college. It teaches you how to college and it teaches you how to college at MTSU. So that is a course that comes highly recommended. Some students will be required to take it. I'll talk a little bit more about that later on in the presentation. But for those that are not required, it's optional. But it is, again, it's highly recommended. We truly encourage students to consider taking that course during the first semester at MTSU. The second thing I want to discuss is Rater Learning Community Pairing. So we have Rater Learning Communities, and what those courses are, two courses that are paired together. professors work together in terms of content, and sometimes there'll be projects that you may work on in one course that'll carry over in the other class. But the other unique thing about the learning communities is that you're in the class, you're in two classes with the exact same people. So it really does allow you to build a sense of community with those, with your classmates, because you become familiar with each other. You see each other in those two courses. Professors work together. So if you have an interest in Radar Learning Community, and even if you don't, I generally will recommend, hey, have you thought about this? Because it's a good opportunity to feel connected at MTSU. Tutoring availability is something we offer to students. We offer to all students. It's free. It is housed in our library in an area that we have coined the tutoring spot. We have tutoring offerings for many, many courses. And so that is an area, a resource we want to make available. We want you to know about, know that it is available to you. And we encourage students to utilize it. We don't want you to wait until midterms or final exam time, but utilize tutoring if you need it and for the entire semester. And then there's Scholars Academy and the STAR program. Those are two early arrival programs that we have for students, for first year students. Scholars Academy begins 2 weeks before the first day of classes, and then STAR program begins a week before. They're programs that are designed to really help students acclimate, become comfortable at MTSU. You learn the campus, you interact with professors and staff, you are able to participate in workshops, you will engage and interact with peer mentors. So they're both great programs to help you to jumpstart your college experience. So you can tell students that attend Scholars in the STAR program. We knew when the students that didn't attend the program come on campus, they're sometimes lost and are really unsure about what to do. And the Scholars and STAR students, they have their grounding. They're ready, and they just jump right into the semester, comfortable, knowledgeable about the university, and ready to go. So two programs, I encourage you to definitely check those out. And then a little bit about coursework toward program of study, which we call CPOS. This is basically a federal regulation that if a student is using federal financial aid in the form of federal loans, federal grants, scholarship, work study, that federal aid will not pay out, or will only pay out if you are taking courses that fall under your degree program. So what does that look like as an undecided student? Undecided students take general education courses. As long as you're taking your general education courses, your financial aid should pay out accordingly. So now let's get down to general education requirements and what they entail. So our general education requirements consist of 41 credits total. They are comprised of different categories, which I'll begin to expound on. The first, however, area that's listed on this sheet is freshman seminar. And freshman seminar is not a general education requirement. As I mentioned before, it is an optional course, although may be required for some. So it's not calculated into the 41 credit hours that that is required for general education. It's on the sheet because, again, we want to make sure that students know that it's available and it's something that we do recommend. Communications, the first category under general education requirements, consists of 9 credits. Most of our courses are 3 credit courses, or 3 credit hours. So with under communications, you have English 1010, English 1020, and Communication 2200. Those are each 3 credit courses, 3 credit hour courses, which tabulate up to the 9 credits. So fulfilling these 3 courses will allow you to meet the communications requirements. The next section is humanities or fine arts. This section requires, again, 3 courses, 9 credits total. Now, 6 of the credits can be from any of the courses that are in this upper category. They can be general humanities or fine art courses. The last 3 credits, or the last course that you will take in this category, will be a literature course. So one of the 3 courses here, English 2020, English 2030, or Humanities 2610, are the options that you have in order to fulfill that humanities literature requirement. With the 1 course here and the 2 that you can take from this area above, they calculate to the 9 credits or the 3 courses for that category. The next section is mathematics. So you can see here, 3 credits, choose 1. The university only requires 1 course or 3 credits of math. There are a variety of math courses that are available below, and based on students' ACT score and major that you're looking at, again, we want to be strategic in terms of which math course that you will select. The next category is history, and it's actually US history. We require 6 credits, so 2 courses. Out of the 3 courses that are listed below, you will take 2 to complete this requirement. They don't have to be taken in any particular order, so you can take US History 2 before you take US History 1, or you may not even take US History 1, you may just do US History 2 and Tennessee History. But these are the history requirements for general education. And then we have the natural sciences area, and that's this area above here. Then within natural sciences, students have to fulfill 2 of the courses. You can see here, though, they're 8 hours, and that's because all of our science courses come with a 1-hour lab. So you will have the 3-hour lecture and then the 1-hour lab that will get you 4 credits per science course, or 8 credits for the 2. So those are the science offerings that will allow you to fulfill the general education credits within that category. And then the last section is social and behavioral sciences. And again, it's choosing 2, so 6 credits, choosing 2 of the 3-hour courses that are provided or listed below. Now, one thing to note in the humanities section, the natural sciences, and the social and behavioral sciences section, when you're selecting those courses, they have to be of 2 different subject matters. So under humanities, you wouldn't select 2 history courses or 2 art courses to fulfill that requirement. They have to be in 2 different subjects. Likewise in natural sciences and social and behavioral sciences. Now this box below references a couple of courses that end with K, like English 1010 K and Read 1000 K. I'm gonna talk a little bit more about what the K courses are, but in essence, they are prescribed courses. And some students will have to take prescribed courses based on ACT or high school GPA. So again, I'm gonna talk about that a little bit more, but I do want you to be aware of this box and the characters that are listed and how they coincide with the courses on this general education form, because if you are taking prescribed courses, then this box will be of relevance to you. So when we have the advising meeting, when you meet with your advisor, myself or a different advisor on day 1 or day 2 of customs, when you finish, you'll have a form that looks like this. And this is our advising worksheet. And what we have provided Jane Doe, quote unquote, is a schedule. So these are the classes that Jane Doe is preparing to take or register for, the number of hours for the corresponding course. And then we've also listed some alternate courses in the event that one of the classes don't work out, don't fit into the schedule that she's trying to prepare. So each student will have a worksheet, an advising worksheet upon completion of your advising session, and it will help you as you begin to register. Now, I mentioned prescribed classes, so I want to share a little bit of information about that with you. These are college courses that come with additional support. So that support, what does that look like? Smaller class sizes and a little bit extra instruction time. So where instead of a class meeting for 50 minutes, 3 days a week, that prescribed course may meet for 1 hour and 5 minutes or 1 hour and 10 minutes. So the idea behind prescribed courses, they are college level courses, but they're built in with that support. So you may have more individualized time with the professor and also more learning time. A student is required to take prescribed courses if they have low or no ACT scores and or if they have a lower high school GPA. So as your advisor, I would have that information and I would share with you whether or not you fall within that category. If you do have to take prescribed courses, the subject for those courses include English, math, history and reading combination, as well as university seminar. So the university seminar, which I spoke about when we were looking at the general education requirements, is the University 1010 course. Now that course is actually required if you have to take 2 prescribed courses. So if you have to take prescribed English and math, you will automatically take University 1010K. These prescribed courses must be taken within the first semester of you attending MTSU, There may be an exception given depending on how many prescribed courses you are required to take, but based on university policy, you have to take them the first semester. And again, we will discuss if you're in that fall in this category where you have to take prescribed courses, we will discuss them when we have your one-on-one advising meeting so that you're clear and you understand the courses that you need to register for. And then quickly, earned college credit. Some of you may have taken AP classes in high school, you may have participated in dual enrollment program, or you may have received a subscore within an ACT on your ACT testing within a category where you're able to receive college credit. If you do fall in this category, you need to submit your transcripts or test scores to MTSU so that you can receive that actual college credit. The only way that credit can be applied is if we have your official test scores or the official transcripts. So I will ask about your involvement, if you were involved in dual enrollment or if you took AP classes when we meet during your advising session before registration. But just know that if we don't have those official documents, they will not be included as college credit here. So I think that's quite a bit of information to share with you, and we will recap some of this during day one of customs. But the challenge right now is if you have questions about any of the information that I share with you, please make note of that and be ready to ask those questions when we have our Meet Your Major session. And if you're parent or family members and you have questions, we'll also have a time where we will talk specifically with you and address your questions. Please come ready on day one with questions about any of the information that I shared. And also, when you arrive on campus, if you need me for anything, I'm located in Peck Hall 142 within the Office of Student Success. And you can also find my email address below, as well as the contact information again for Rodney and Dr. Sluder. I am excited to meet you all. I cannot wait to see you on day one of customs, and I'm looking forward to having you on campus this fall. So I'll see you on day one of customs. And if you have questions in the meantime, please feel free to reach out to me. Have a good one.